Hi everyone, welcome to peepinmoon.com. I'm Rashita Sani and today we have with us two very special guests who are currently enjoying the success of their recently released show Ashram. Today we have with us Darshan Kumar and Aditi Pohankar. Hi guys, welcome to Peepin Moon. So firstly, I was very curious to know the reviews are out now and your particular performances have been praised. So did you, you know, at first when you were doing it, did you expect such, you know, so much love and appreciation for your roles?
Ladies first, would you like to start?
Okay, sure.
That's fine, Aditi.
Yeah, Rashita and me have spoken, I think, just 3-4 months ago. And
she.
Yeah, so, yes. So, I did expect a good review or a good show for real, because it was Prakash sir and I knew that he makes very good content which goes and reaches every part of the country for sure, because his topics are such that it will intrigue anybody who will be in a space who wants to know what's happening in the world, in the sense of you know, if it's like going to be a change that's going to be coming along or what. And I think Prakash sir has the courage to put forward his foot and stand with bravery, saying that look, this is what I want to talk to you about, and which is what I think cinema is per se to begin with about, you know. So I think playing this character, honestly, I didn't really have the guts to ask Prakash sir that, you know, what's the part, or can I first read it? I did try once and then I was like, okay sir, no problem, whatever you're doing is great, because that's true. I know, I mean, I didn't know at that point when I was doing She, I didn't know that I'll get to play a character which is like this, you know, who's again going to be the how to say, I mean, Haryanvi to uska ek side tha, but the kind of courage the girl has in the script, you know, because the courage which I felt in She also, which was subdued, and then how it came up like a, you know, like a blast, which was amazing, the way Imtiaz had also written it. So I think I'm just very lucky and fortunate that everybody's saying 2020 is a year to be forgotten, but I think for me 2020 is the year that I was like extremely excited, you know. I was like, shit.
Yeah.
One after the other, two shows are becoming such liked by people. I don't know about hit and flop. I just know that people are liking a certain thing. And it's bringing out two different sides of the society in Ashram. At the same time, and She also it did. And I had the opportunity to play this innocent young girl who is like, you know, just lost in her own beautiful world, has dreams, ambitions, and who wants to, you know, not bogged down by any kind of incapacities of the society, which she stands up for and then puts her faith in, gets colored by it, understands the reality of the situation at that point, and then you'll see what happens, because she's not going to stop where right now we have stopped. She's just going to go all out.
Okay, that's great. And Darshan, what about you?
As we all know, Prakash is one of the best directors in our industry, and I have, you know, I admire him like anything. So he's a living legend. And since I have grown up watching his films, which are full of content, entertaining, thrilling, and with a, you know, great message. So it was my dream to come. It was my dream to work with him. And when he approached me for this Ashram, I was like, "Sir, I'm doing it." I did not ask, as Aditi said, about the role and at all. And I said, "No, no, sir. I'm just doing it. You tell me when and where I have to reach." So when you are planning to start the shooting. So I was that much excited, and I was sure this is going to rock, and touch wood, we are getting that kind of response right now.
And what about like sharing screen space with, as you said that, you know, working with Prakash Jha was incredible, and then sharing screen space with Bobby Deol, he has been in the industry for so long. Was there anything that you guys could inculcate from him, either in your acting skill or the way you work, or any advice or tip that you received from him?
You know, there is saying you are blessed when your co-star is a talented actor, because two good actors can create a magic on celluloid magic on screen. So I can say like I had two things in that. Plus, I got a talented and hardworking actor, and plus such a beautiful soul. He's such a beautiful soul, like, you know, I have ever met. He's so genuine, so down to earth, so passionate about his work. We were discussing work all the time wherever we were sitting. And, you know, we, you know, sharing those tips to each other, because he's so senior. He has done lots of, a lot of good movies. So I had a great time working with him, and I love him so much.
Great. And Aditi, what about you?
Sorry, what was your question?
Being with Bobby Deol, did you get a chance to sort of inculcate something from him in your acting skills, or did any, you know, did he get a chance to give you any advice or tip?
Well, I would say he's one of the best co-actors I have worked with. In spite of being Bobby Deol, he was more like, हम जैसे थिएटर में करते हैं ना कि चल यार लाइंस करते हैं, यू नो, और वो जितने बार तुम लाइंस करो ना उसका अलग अलग मजा आता रहता है. एंड दैट इज व्हाट आई सॉ, सरप्राइज दैट बॉबी सर वाज लाइक यू नो एक्साइटेड अबाउट दैट, बिकॉज़ उस ठंड में हम साइड में कहीं बैठ के इज लाइक चल अदिति लाइंस करते हैं, यू नो. एंड देन आई रिमेंबर दैट वी यूज्ड टू से सर्टेन थिंग्स इन अ सर्टेन वे, एंड आई वाज लाइक सर आई विल टेक दिस ओवर हियर, इज लाइक हां यू डू व्हाटएवर यू हैव टू डू. सो the level of comfort which was there, which I see in people who are like Darshan said, that yes, he's passionate certainly, and he's really excited about doing something at this point of his life, and he keeps talking about it like a child, you know. He's like, I remember once I told him that kal meri chutti hai, I'm so happy about it and all that, and he's like, you know, don't feel like tumhe kaam agar mil raha hai abhi, you should feel lucky about it. So I said, I didn't mean to say it in that way, that I was bored to work, but I was like, at least one day we are getting a break, I'll sit in my blanket, you know, that is what I thought. But what he told me was exactly the truth, that when you have work, you got to value it and you got to be grateful for it at that point of time. So I think if this is the thinking that he has at this stage, I really, I mean, I am very happy that I got to be his co-star, and because my track is mostly with Bobby sir and Tushar, and I think that was one blessing, because Tushar again is a terrific actor. He's always there in the scene and he's always present. Agar tumhe lines change karni hai to he's always helpful. So I think overall the cast is terrific of Ashram. So hats off to Shruti.
And Darshan, your character has been named as a conflicted character, even in the reviews that have come out. So, आपका जब आप start कर रहे थे मतलब इस show के लिए, आपका क्या approach था अपने role को लेकर?
Yeah, it's a very challenging role, I can say. I remember when sir told me about this role, because I'm playing Sub Inspector Ujagar Singh, and he's very diligent police officer and a go-getter. His elder brother is an IPS officer and father is a DIG. So since his childhood, he wanted to join police force, but due to the quota system in our country, he couldn't clear the IPS exams. So, you know, he was so frustrated, but he still wanted to pursue his dream. And he thought, I'll join, I'll do whatever I want to do, and I have to prove myself. So he joined as a sub-inspector. But, you know, this character has lots of layers, which makes it very challenging. And I think that's what any actor's delight. So I thoroughly enjoyed playing Ujagar Singh, and I don't think there is any kind of controversy about that. So, but lots of that characters' conflicts are there, which I enjoyed playing.
Yeah. Okay. And Aditi, when I saw the show, I was like, you are the perfect fit. Your dialect was perfect. The way you looked, the way you talked, your body language, everything matched. It didn't look like you were acting. So what did you do to make it look so natural?
With accents, I would say that I love doing accents. Like, I love doing body language accents, because I think that's what brings a character to life. You know, now if you talk about three maids that I have had in the last few days, those three maids were maids only, but they had a certain different nuance to their living. And I really enjoy doing that. So I do observe a lot of people. I do mimic a lot of people. And for fun's sake only, we do that, you know, at home also and otherwise with my co-actors and friends. So I think from what I started off, with Sunita ji, I started the diction because I was not very well versed with Haryanvi. Never even heard Haryanvi even once. I've even been to Delhi only once, you know. So Delhi is the closest to these places and I've never been there. So then I'm like, dude, how do I do this now? Because Prakash sir is very sure that he wants to cast me, even though I'm from Bombay and I'm, you know, this kind of person. So I start off with Sunita ji, who's an excellent diction coach, I think. And then luckily I get somebody called Sangram Singh, who's a wrestler, world champion. And he's a trainer himself. And he's coming to coach me. And I was like, wow, what more do I want, you know? So I go to the wrestling arena and I start hanging out with those girls. And basically they gave me a first hand class. Like I just had to know my lines, which I did in the beginning when I went from Bombay. And once I went there, maine usse bas dhache mein dal diya with those girls, because they were wrestlers, they were in front of me and they were talking the way I should be talking. So it was very simple. Of course, to hear it is simple, to do it is difficult because we were shooting at the same time. But I think I picked it up from there and I was lucky enough to have that 4 days time to prepare for it.
Yeah, that I think it was quite visible when we watched the show.
Oh, thanks a lot.
And what about, so when the trailer released, even though a disclaimer was released before that, there was a certain section on the internet that was trending, a hashtag called Boycott Ashram Web Show. So it was, you know, people had some comments to make. Do you think, even though the show did not show any bad light on any religion or anything of that sort, people tried to, you know, think of their own before the show even released? Do you think that the Indian audience still is very sensitive when it comes to any topic that is even slightly close to sort of Hinduism or religion?
See, first of all, I'd like to say it's a fictional show. It's not based on any person or our community. And we respect all the religions, you know. We do not want to hurt anyone's spiritual feelings. Mm-hmm. So I think we made this show because we wanted to warn people about con men and how dangerous blind faith can be. So, and then now people are realizing after watching our show, they are tweeting and they are talking about this, like this show is not about particular any religion or any person or community. So it's an amazing show. So I think they got their answer.
True. Yeah. And Aditi, would you like to add on?
I said that Prakash sir is known to, you know, put his stand forward about what he feels about the society, because somebody has to. Who would, take that chance? Because sabhi hamesha bolte hai ki, yaar, chhod do na, why are you getting into it? But Prakash sir is somebody who's saying, I'm getting troubled by it, by something in the society that I have watched. And yes, I want to do something about it. And I make it, I come across with something which is a medium for everybody, that everybody will watch, and with MX Player being free for everybody, it's such a great thing that this show is on MX, because it's gone on every nook and corner of this country. That's why the following, like the viewership, is at this level, and everybody is kind of being warned by something that's happening, which everybody is kind of aware of it and unaware of it at the same time, because we don't really want to know. This is a completely fictional show, not based on any particular god man or anything like that, but it's a certain idea. Abhi jaise ki hame bachpan mein warn kiya jata hai ki wahan pe gadda hai, mat jana, gir jao. It's exactly what Prakash sir is doing. He's saying, dekho maine suna hai ye sab kuch hai shayad pure world mein, aise nahi bol rahe ki sirf India mein hai ya kahin aur hai. एक तरीके की इंसानियत है, एक तरीके की इंसानियत को नीचे लाने की कोशिश हो रही है, जिसके लिए हम शायद आवाज उठा सकते हैं, और वो भी सत्याग्रह वाले जोन में जाके नहीं. वी आर जस्ट टॉकिंग अबाउट इट इन अ सिनेमैटिक पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, एंड आई थिंक दिस इज द ओनली पीसफुल वे वी कैन प्रोबेबली आगाह कर सकते हैं लोगों को कि वॉच आउट फॉर योरसेल्फ, यू नो, यूज योर माइंड, वॉच आउट फॉर योरसेल्फ, एंड दैट्स द मैसेज आई थिंक प्रकाश सर सर्टेनली पुट इन फॉरवर्ड.
या दैट्स ट्रू. या And what about any update on the season 2? Because I'm sure whoever has watched the first season is wanting to know more about what's going to come next.
It's coming soon, and I think Prakash ji and the MX player is they are the right person to talk about it and say announce the date. But I think it will release soon. Yeah.
The part two, part two.
Okay, and what about this web space? Both of you have had like a successful run, as you mentioned about She also, and even Darshan, you have been doing really great in this space. Do you think it's the next ball game for you?
Yes, obviously. I think OTT platform has opened up a new horizon, not only for actors but for producers, writers, directors, technicians, for everyone. And the OTT platform has, this has made entertainment very accessible to the people. Now they are watching their favorite content anytime or anywhere, and they are watching all international content. So this has made our filmmakers very cautious about what they are making. Now they have to make something which is on par with international content. So yeah, the OTT platform has done a lot of good in terms of good work as well. So we all actors are having great time.
Yeah. Okay. Anaditi?
Yes, because I feel like the kind of recognition I got in She world over was something I didn't expect at that point of time. And I thought that, okay, maybe it's just because of Corona or something like that. And as the show went ahead for a whole month, because people were telling me that, you know, it's a lockdown. So, but for a whole month, that kind of appreciation, I was like, this is because of OTT. You know, there's no other way that I could be popular, a newcomer will be popular for a whole month because of the performance, in theatres. I mean, yes, my earlier film did run for a very long time again. Laibhari was running for 3 months that we didn't know about. But that kind of, first-hand information that you keep getting on your DM, that makes your day, man. Every day you're like, wow, yay, this is happening. Like with Ashram, everybody's so excited now. Yeah. The whole cast is excited. And it's become quite a big success. It's a hit, I'm sure. Now in a few days, we'll get to know more. But I think that first-hand information that an actor gets, you know, so I reply to everybody because I'm like, dude, thanks, man. You watched it for me. And, you know, it's like making it popular. So thanks. So I think OTT is... people will want to do more OTT now, or like Darshan said, that people who are doing films will be now cautioned that yes, content the kya bolte grahak jagta hai waise audience jaag gaya hai ab tumhe acha kuch bana ke hi dena hoga nahi to log sahi mein nikal jayenge. So it's a pressure on everybody, and because of which the art will flourish now. I think it's that time.
Yeah, definitely. I think I agree with you too. And I think everyone's hoping to see you all soon with Ashram Season 2.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much for chatting with me. All the very best for your future.
Thanks for having us. Thank you. Take care.
Welcome.
Bye. Yeah, take care.